Previously on Bobby's Perspective, the bombshell hit. His team was forced to change their Wikipedia page. What happened to little Edward Gaunt? How did he become Earthling Ed? Television, film, and moving image. Now, why would they want to keep that a secret? Edward Gaunt. Underneath, script supervisor Lorna Note. Meet beautiful Lorna. Lorna is Luna. As we established in the first episode of the series, Twigs and Grass Ltd. is a private company. We can see on the company's house register that Ed knows exactly what he's doing. Why is his girlfriend even a director and a shareholder? Total share capital is 100 shares. Ed has 25 shares, his girlfriend has 25 as well. The other 50 are owned by Kirsty Adams. Most people don't understand company formation. Those shares are for profit. They can be sold. As they own half the company between them, it is highly unlikely that the third director could even block the sale. It makes no sense whatsoever why a private investor would give them such a massive shareholding, especially in a not-for-profit business. Having half the company is indicative of them putting up half of the investment. This is highly likely, and his claim about a private investor is covering up them pocketing donations. The scam loop is very obvious. Money from Unity Diner allegedly going to Search, which is not even a registered company or charity.
And I was approached by an individual who had seen the work that I had done through Search and the work that we had done through Search, and he said that he wanted to help us and he saw a lot of potential in what we were doing and he thought that what we were doing was effective and had a lot of potential for the future. So he said that he wanted to help us, but in particular he wanted to help us get to a point where we could be financially sustainable. And so we came up with this idea, and this is where I am today. This idea is manifest into this tangible place that's real. And the idea that we had was that we were going to open up an entirely non-profit vegan diner where we'd serve delicious vegan food, but all the profits made from the establishment would be put into Surge to mean that we could really just take on all the projects we wanted to take on and do all the things that we talked about and dreamt of and wrote about and thought about. We could actually make them achievable and accomplishable projects. And that's exactly where I am today. I'm in that 100% non-profit vegan diner. It's called Unity Diner.
You just heard Edward Gaunt talk about the private investor, but gives us no further information other than referring to them as he. Edward Gaunt keeps on saying it's 100% not for profit. Oh, really? So why do you have shares in it, Ed? If that was true and a private investor wanted to set up a not for profit vegan restaurant, they would not give Ed and his girlfriend a directorship along with shares in the business. They are not minor shareholders. They own half of the company, which entitles them to half of the profit. No philanthropist would do that. They had no intention of making it not for profit. A private investor would know that they could not get those shares back of Ed and his girlfriend. The investor would know that they could not suddenly switch to a charity or a non-profit company. Ed has never revealed who the investor is. Could it be Moving Mountains? Why else would Unity Diner use that supplier? They are not KFC or McDonald's who now have vegan options. Customers know the link those outlets have to the meat industry. Unity Diner, on the other hand, is meant to be an ethical vegan restaurant. It has total control over its supply chain. Therefore, it's inexcusable to use moving mountains. Unity Diner was incorporated over a year ago. Ed had all the time to register it as a not-for-profit, which also gives them tax relief and deductions. If you were truly raising money for animal activism, you would be losing out having it as a private limited company. You would be hit with high corporation tax on the profits. Not great for those poor animals. On the Search Animal Activism homepage, which Ed Gaunt set up in 2016, we can see the donation button. On the donation page, as you can see, it claims the company is pursuing status as a UK registered charity. How contrived and convenient that they make that statement on the donations page. It takes, on average, 40 days to register as a charity in the UK. The statement has been there for several months at least. Putting it on the donation page just shows you how calculated they are. Search is not even registered at company's house. Therefore, there are no accounts available, no records, no way of knowing what the donations are used for. From just one Patreon page alone, he receives over $7,000 per month. His blind followers think their money is being used for animal activism. No one is going to question Saintly Ed, the vegan Jesus. Since 2016, he had 3 years to register as a charity, but hasn't. Bottom line is, there is no way of knowing what the profit is or how the funds are used. The website doesn't even reveal who the mystery team is. When you ask for donations for animal activism, those donations are not your money. That's why charities register and are given a charity number. The public can then verify that they are a genuine charity with accounts. They have had 3 years to do this. On this homepage, we can take a closer look. Non-profit organizations are formed to pursue a goal, not for profit or for any of the proceeds to go to its members or leaders. These organizations don't have commercial owners and must rely on funds from contributions, membership fees, events, and investment income, among other things. The money made is spent solely on the organization's aims and running costs. Non-profit organizations don't have owners, and so there is no owner's equity, stockholders' equity, and no distribution to owners. Here you can clearly see the benefits. Exemption from state and local income taxes, property taxes, franchise taxes, or sales taxes. A charity, of course, has to be transparent. The statement reports the revenue, expenses, gains, and loss of an NFP for a specified period, usually 1 year. This statement is mandatory, since the aim of a non-profit organization is to provide for society. the summarized transaction accounts are declared in the revenues and expenses part of the statement. Membership fees, program fees, fundraising events, grants and contributions all count as revenues that should be reported in the accounting period that they were earned, not when they were received. Now, let's talk about Ed's Mystery Animal Sanctuary.
They would also know that they're supporting a good cause and a good movement, and their money has been put towards effective campaigns and spreading this message as much as Serge and myself possibly can. But we've often spoken about the creation of a Serge Animal Sanctuary, a sanctuary for rescued animals. And so the profits from Unity Dino will also go towards the creation and funding of the Serge Sanctuary, a new sanctuary here in England. And so at Serge, we want to create a new sanctuary, and Unity Dino will give us the ability to actually do that. And so every time that you eat here and you eat the vegan, the delicious vegan food that we'll be serving, not only will you be supporting kind of grassroots activism and all other things, you'll also be supporting the creation of a new sanctuary here in the UK.
That was back in 2018. There has not been a single update on this, despite there being donation platforms.
We also know that they're supporting a good money to a good movement, their money is being put towards effective campaigns and spreading this message as much as Serge and myself possibly can. But we've often spoken about the creation of a Serge Animal Sanctuary, sanctuary for rescue animals. And so the profits from Unity Dino will also go towards the creation and funding of the Serge Sanctuary, a new sanctuary here in England. So at Serge, we want to create a new sanctuary, and Unity Dino will give us the ability to actually do that. And so every time that you meet here and you meet the vegan, the delicious vegan food that we'll be serving, not only will you be supporting kind of grassroots activism and all other things, you'll also be supporting the creation of a new sanctuary here in the UK.
Serge website says, more information coming in mid-2019. Sure. Why is he opening a new sanctuary rather than supporting an existing one? Especially as most sanctuaries are seriously underfunded. Well, if he supported an existing one, he would have to provide them with actual money. Edward Gaunt and his girlfriend Lorna Note claimed they filmed abuse in UK farms. Everyone in the UK knows who the RSPCA is. It defies belief that someone would film animal abuse and would not immediately call the RSPCA. The RSPCA would have been there within hours to rescue the animals and would probably have shut down the farm too. That wouldn't have been great for film footage though, right? There is a rumor cursing among ex-vegans and animal rights dropouts. There are underground reports of so-called vegans paying workers to commit the abuse so that they can film it. This might sound ridiculously far-fetched, but reading the statement from the RSPCA does make one wonder. This film is clearly very upsetting, and we are concerned about the footage, particularly given claims some of it was taken on an RSPCA assured farm. If Edward Gaunt or Lorna Note had an ounce of compassion for the animals, they would have called the RSPCA right away. His deception seems so blatant, but people are blindsided when someone waves the animal rights flag. People need to understand that Earthling Ed does not care about animals or ethics. What kind of lunatic films animal abuse and does not report it to the relevant authorities? The vast majority of the population eats meat and would immediately report animal abuse in a heartbeat. But not Ethical Ed. If he had called the police or RSPCA, they could have been there within hours to stop further abuse and rescue the animals. His only concern was getting footage to manipulate people's emotions and get more donations rather than stop the abuse and get the animals rescued. Both
Ed
and his girlfriend were complicit to the abuse. That is the law.
Thank you.